Remember, a physics class is scored on a curve and potential, or partial credit. And my physics class, the curve was 27, and I got an A with a 28, due mostly to my programs. In physics problems ask you to find something, like acceleration, force, work, or something. And then it gives you some variables, like mass or velocity, to work with. Well, in my programs, you use my menu to what is asked for to find also. And then I give you the choice of variables because of the different formulas involved. So let's get started. I'm going to go back here to the main screen here, and you notice there's physics with a closed parenthesis on it. You have to push second alpha and then put the letters PHYSICS in there, and then you have to press alpha and put the closed parentheses in, and then you press enter, and up comes my menu. And this menu has many, many things. You can see the arrow here, which goes way down to all kinds of things, fluids, hydraulics, and center of mass, and anything you might. I can't get everything in there because of the titanium's restrictions on memory, or memory allowances. So, but anyways, let's just do a quick example here. Let's go to acceleration, and we're going to put acceleration in. Now, when you go down the menu, here's these arrow again. You can go way down here, give you many, many choices for acceleration, all kinds of different formulas. And you pick out the one that they give you in your problem. Let's say that it gave you this one here, number 8. You can press 8 and it'll go. And I always show you this A acceleration. This is a funny A, it's not a real A. That's what is designed to do that in physics books. And here's the formula. And we're going to enter the mass. Let's go, you have to press alpha before you enter anything. Let's go 15. I always give you this. This is pretty neat because I'll give you all the choices for, like, sometimes the problem will say grams or sometimes it'll say kilograms. And I give you those choices as you go through any problems programs that I have. I'm going to say it's kilograms. I'm going to show you how it changes, but in a second. And then let's press put an angle of 23 degrees in there. And there's friction force. We're going to push alpha and then put 45 in there, newtons. And I show you what you've entered. But let's just for experimental sake change the 15 gram. Let's say that, and so I'll give you that choice. Let's go back and change it. And we're going to put the mass in of alpha 15, and let's say that it's grams this time, okay? And then we're going to add our angle, which is alpha 23, and then our friction force, which is alpha 45 newtons. You notice that I changed it with it, by dividing by 1,000. You can mess that up in your test or homework, so that I do that for you. For me also. These programs were designed for me first, remember? And we're going to say okay. So here's, you write all this down, A acceleration, here's the formula first. You put in the gravity, you put in the sine of 23 minus 45 is the friction force, and here's the mass and etc. And you just go through it and put it in here, and then you come up with the answer, minus 2,996.2 meters per second squared. Anytime you're dealing with friction force, I don't mean to teach anything, but it's negative because it's opposite to the friction force. So, pretty neat, huh? Check out my site, check out my programs.